Good day, folks. Welcome back to another time video. We have a gooder for you tonight, or today, depending on when you're watching. This is called the Up in Smoke Pupa, and something I played with all year, and something that quickly climbed the ranks for my top cronies. This one is a really good alternative to ASB, especially in small sizes. You can tie this thing as small as you want and not sacrifice your profile at all. Typically 18s with 1/16th beads. It's very tough to use ASB, it's just too thick. So this way you can tie the small bugs, and then in just the regular sizes, like this one, it was absolutely stellar. So, tying a Daiichi 1760, I've got white tying thread, and that's kind of the kicker to get this color. I'm going to tie in some red wire. This is extra small. Pretty much all I use. Bombers, I will go to a small size. And I'll just wrap that back as I usually do. So right to about where the barb is. Now, the body material is smoke buzzer wrap. Now, there's a bunch of, the strands aren't always the same, so I try to pick and choose them. I don't mind if it's a little bit blotchy looking, because then you kind of get that transitional look where it really takes on the look that it's just starting to gas up to emerge. And but it hasn't fully yet, so it's a neat look. Just gonna build this taper up. So this thing was a game changer this year. Not saying there's other bugs that wouldn't have caught fish. Imagine there is, but it certainly did serious work. So just build that taper up to where I'm happy with it. Looks good. And then I'll take that buzzer wrap and just side by side without overlapping too much. So you can see certain ones or certain wraps are a little bit darker than others. And that's that kind of blotchy effect I was talking about. So I try to keep my wraps to a minimum up here at the thorax for now. So just a couple wraps to tie that off. Trim it out nice and close. Grab my wire. Segment the body. Just like so. So two wraps over and one wrap right in behind there is all you need. I'm just gonna spin this out. Got my thread frayed a little bit here. Not a big deal. All right, now, rather than change threads and bulk that up, because it's white, we can kind of do whatever we want with it. So this is a rusty brown marker. And I'm just gonna color that rusty brown real quick, and then come through with just a one kind of a swipe of this orange Sharpie. and that's going to give us kind of a burnt orange color that's perfect for these collars. So you can do that with just about any fly. Come in, whip finish that. Hopefully the frays will trim out. There we go. The marker got on that bead. I can just kind of pluck it out of there or wipe it off of there. Doesn't really make a difference. And there you go. So hopefully you can see that body color is pretty bang on. And come in here with some crazy glue. Just coat that one. And there we go. That's all there is to the Up in Smoke pupa. Deadly, deadly little pattern. As I say, fish it in a white bead, a black bead with some gills, a black bead with no gills, but that body is really, really tough to beat. It's kind of like the old blue dunn, but with a touch more shine to it. So it's just super, super neat the way that looks. And then being not really consistent, kind of being a little bit blotchy, just takes on a little bit more realism. If you get some frays like that, I'll let this dry and then I'll just zip my lighter to it and that'll take care of those, but they're not gonna matter anyway. So that's all there is to it. Give it a try, fish it. I know that one will fish well for you. It, like I say, it smashed all year. So that's a good one. Thanks very much for watching. Give us a thumbs up if you liked it. Subscribe if you haven't. And until the next one, cheers and tight lines.